Several reports released by different human rights organizations have consistently named the Uganda Police Force as one of the main violators of human rights in the country. These reports usually cite the common cases of long detention, brutal arrests, and torture of suspects, among others. In a bid to improve its image and address the concerns over human rights violations, police has organized a retreat for the force's top leadership, where officers like regional police commanders and directors are meeting to discuss ways in which they can improve the running of the police force. While speaking to the officers during the opening of the retreat, Inspector General of Police Martin Zokotho Chola warned the officers against using torture as a method of interrogating suspects.
Someone who has not even abused you, a suspect has not abused you, how do you begin torturing him or her? Mark you, statements recorded from suspect as a result of torture is not acceptable, is not admissible in the court. So why do you waste your time? At least I was trained in the CID, I was trained in special branch. Torture is not a technique in investigations.
Ochola says police officers should desist from abusing the rights of Ugandans during arrest or detention, because such actions taint the image of the police.
You should only use force to the extent that is necessary, proportionate, and reasonable in all the circumstances. One time it went viral when some police officers, I think in Kajas, were torturing someone or some people for being members of people power. Is it an offense to belong to people power? Under what section in the penal code?
The IGP also emphasized the need to promote discipline within the force, and he warned the police leadership against using crime preventers in police operations, saying they have since been attached to the reserve force of the UPDF.
They are part of the reserve force of the army. Now, if I get you with a crime preventer at your station, RPCs, unless he's an ordinary Mwananchi who has brought information, intelligence information to you, not as a crime preventer, as an ordinary Mwananchi, for you to use that person to go and arrest that crime preventer, go and arrest, we shall arrest you first.
Meanwhile, police has put a halt on issuing new licenses for private security companies. According to the IGP, these companies have to first be evaluated to ascertain their performance over the years.
We have every year to evaluate the performance of these private security companies before we renew their licenses. There are those whose staff are perpetually committing crimes. There are those who have failed to pay our funds, the guns, the rent. So I want this committee to go and evaluate performance evaluation of each private security company. That will be a basis for renewing their licenses.
The IGP has also warned the police against corrupt tendencies like receiving bribes, selling police bonds, and criminalizing civil matters. The IGP has reiterated that police is in the process of building its capacity in both human resources and equipment needed to carry out its duties. Juma Kiria, NTV.
That's right.